the gospel today, Jesus is speaking to his disciples about John the Baptist, who is in prison at that time. And he says, among those born of women, none is greater than John. Jesus honored John for being called by God to be the prophet to announce the coming of Christ. Yet John was now in prison, and it would be a matter of time before he would lose his life. Jesus also recognizes another thing. He says, the kingdom of heaven is suffering violence, and the violent take it by force. He seems to be lamenting the fact that there are those who are actively opposed to the kingdom of God, those who do violence against the kingdom of God, violence against John the Baptist, violence against Jesus, violence against people of faith. We have the example of St. John of the Cross today, whose own Carmelite community persecuted him and imprisoned him, did him violence because of his attempt to reform that community. You know, when we look back on our human history, some historians have characterized human history as a history of war and violence. Just take the two world wars of the last century. More deaths among civilians than among all combatants, among all soldiers. There were more civilians killed than those actually fighting each other. And today's society shows us a great deal of terrorism and violence and pain. And sad to say, it's likely to continue this way for the remainder of human history. And even when we look to the future, we see violence. I was thinking about all the excitement about the next movie, the next Star Wars episode. The name itself says it, Star Wars. War is the key dynamic of the plot. So we may ask ourselves, will we ever be free of violence and war? Probably not, because as long as people give in to their emotions of anger, hatred, jealousy, envy, revenge, there will be violence. As long as we allow issues such as politics, religion, economics, sexual orientation, skin color, and more to divide us, we will experience violence. So Jesus was correct in his assessment. The kingdom of heaven suffers violence. Yet here we are in a season that talks all about peace and joy. We anticipate the birthday of the Prince of Peace. Jesus came to offer reconciliation to the human family, between its members and between the humanity, human family and God. He came to offer a peaceful solution to conflict, which is forgiveness. With forgiveness and mercy, we can bring an end to violence. It might seem like a pipe dream, but the willingness to forgive can transform our violent world into a peaceful kingdom of grace and mercy and love. But that peaceful kingdom has to begin within each of us. It has to begin here. So when Jesus returns to us someday and brings human history to its fulfillment, he will usher in that kingdom of peace. In the kingdom of God, there will be no room for violence and conflict or anger, and those who cannot repent of such things will be excluded, and those who are willing to repent of these things will be welcomed. So during Advent, we keep up our prayer for world peace, especially